Hey guys, it's Brian with Elevate Woodworks, and today we're doing a how-to video with Cotton Life on how to make a cooler speaker system. And this is a really great project that a lot of people have done at home with a set of old car speakers, a car head unit, even a car battery sometimes. And it works well, except it's really heavy and it really cuts down on your storage space inside the cooler. So what we're going to talk about today is how to do it with anything you can buy at a home improvement store or a few places online, and it's going to cost you under $100. And the main thing is a cooler. I chose this because it's small, it has wheels, and it's easy to transport. Half the time whenever you load one up with drinks and food, you're stuck carrying it. So might as well make it easier for yourself. It still holds 22 cans, or so they say, and so I think it's a really good place to start. We've already gone ahead and cut out the cavities for everything, but we'll talk about that later. Next, you want to make sure you get a Class D amp and speakers. These came from PartsExpress.com. This is a $10 amp and it's 20 watts. So basically it'll give you two channels and it's really small but really powerful. You'll be surprised. Next, we have these speakers that go with it. They're 8-ohm speakers to match with the amp, and they're 2-inch speakers. They don't look like much and they're small, but they're pretty loud paired with the right amp. The most important thing is you want to make sure that you have the right wattage pairing between the two. Bigger isn't always better. Second, we're going to go with this Bluetooth module. We got this from Best Buy. It's $26, and basically it's going to allow us to have Bluetooth connectivity between our phone to the amp. We don't want to use an auxiliary cord. It's just going to get in the way, and you'll see why later. Next, we have this battery that we got off of eBay. I believe it's around $20, and it's real simple. It has a power plug for the amp and a charging side too. These are just the wires that go with the speaker. And this is what everything's going to go inside. This is basically a Tupperware that's gonna mount to the front. And we're gonna have everything in here. It's gonna keep everything waterproof and tight. So you can keep your phone, your wallet, your keys, and you don't have to worry about it going anywhere. These are just kind of some smaller things you might need. A Forstner bit or a hole saw. And we'll talk about these later on why you might want one or the other, but those are good to have. Cheap set of box cutters. These are about $2 at Walmart. Velcro and silicone sealant. So the whole point of this project is we want it to be easy and we don't want to spend a lot of money on it. So with that said, we only need a few tools to do the job. To cut out the speaker holes, you can either use a Forstner bit or a hole saw. I prefer to use the Forstner bit because I used a drill press, that way it kind of held it still for me and I didn't have to worry about it jumping around. Whenever you use a hole saw, you have a pilot bit, so you can do it with a drill and basically this will hold it for you so nothing bad happens. To cut out this main hole, I would recommend using a cheap box cutter, these are a couple bucks at the store, and heat it up really hot. Once you trace the outline to your Tupperware, just go through and cut out that line. You might have to reheat it a couple times, but it's much easier that way. Once you've cut it, you just scoop out the foam. Another thing we're going to need is a drill with a 1/4-inch bit. Once we have the Tupperware placed in its cavity, we're going to drill holes in the side so that we can run the wires for the speakers. The next step of the process is that we need to drill the holes for the speaker wire to get into the actual Tupperware. And you just want to make sure that you can get the holes as far back in the speaker hole and the Tupperware as you can so that we don't interfere with anything once we start putting electronics in. Next, we just want to cut through this foam. We want to make sure that the speakers can get from their holes into the Tupperware. And it's pretty easy. You just want to get a little box cutter like this, and we're just going to cut right through. It's real soft. Just a little pathway for the wires to get through. I'm going to push that through. Simple as that. So here's our speaker wire. We've got the JCT2 connector on one side, which comes with it, and you need to add your own connectors on the other side. I made the mistake of doing this beforehand, so I had to go ahead and drill a bigger hole. It's about 3/8 now, and you won't have any problem getting this through. So now that we have our speaker wire run, we want to go ahead and put all of our electronics in the Tupperware. The best way to do that is I'm just going to use Velcro. If we ever need to replace something in the future or get something out of the way, this is the easiest way to do it. The first thing I'm going to do is I've got the Bluetooth module and the amp connected. And I've already placed the Velcro in here to start off with, so we just want to make sure that our amp It's easily accessible if you ever want to change that volume knob or put something next to it. Next, we want to make sure that our Bluetooth module has the button facing up. There's only one button on this, so it's pretty important. Next, we have our battery. We're going to go ahead and put this to where we can still reach the switch, but as close to these these electronics as we can. Now we're going to go ahead and just connect everything. So next, we just want to mount our speakers and connect them. So the first thing we want to do is make sure that you have your connectors nice and tight, and also that you've drilled your hole deep enough so that we have enough clearance. So go ahead and get those connected. So the next thing we want to do is we want to make sure everything works before we start screwing things down. So go ahead and turn your battery on, get your Bluetooth paired to your phone or whatever device you're going to use. And go ahead and adjust this volume knob once you get it going to make sure that the volume here leaves room for your phone to still be adjusted. So now we're going to go ahead and just screw down these speakers. I'm going to do it by hand because if you had a drill, it'd be really easy to strip out that plastic. So go ahead and just do it and make sure they're nice and snug. So the next thing we want to do is we really want to make sure that this Tupperware doesn't go anywhere whenever we're wheeling it down the sidewalk or getting out of the car. And although it is snug in here, we want to add some sort of adhesive to make sure it stays. So what I have here is I have liquid nails, clear seal. It's going to give us a strong but flexible hold, nothing that's going to crack and eventually just break free. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put this underneath and add a lot down here. Go ahead and press that down and make sure it spreads evenly. Next, we're going to go ahead and line the outer edge with silicone. I'm not too worried about keeping this thing waterproof. I don't think it's ever going to get wet. And if it did, we would use a waterproof speaker instead. This is more to kind of clean up these rough edges and make sure that none of this foam or anything like that becomes mildewed or gets moisture inside. And for the final step, we're just going to go ahead and add a bottle opener. And there you have it. Now you have a cooler with all the capacity that we started with. We have a great sound system, and we have a battery and amplifier combination that are going to last us all day. We have a Bluetooth module that's easy to use. You won't have any issues pairing to any of your devices. We have a bottle opener, so we're ready to go with any beverage that we want. And most importantly, we have a waterproof Tupperware that's going to keep all of our valuables inside, no matter what we're doing, safe and in one spot.